Welcome back to another episode of Quick 30 Podcast, family. You feel me? I got my
Yes,
man
sir.
Zay in the building right here. You know what I'm saying?
What's up, family?
What's up, man? How you feeling today, bro?
Chilling, bro. You already know what it is, man. It's a lot of topics in the sports world today, bro. But let them know what we finna talk about today, man.
Hey, man. Like I said, we do all sports. You feel me? We talk about all sports, not just football, not just about basketball. I love baseball too, but not just about baseball. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot about boxing too, you know. For y'all out there, y'all need to be tuning in to Stephen Fulton and my man's new too. New is the number two ranked pound for pound boxer in the world. He just knocked Stephen Fulton's head off. But that's not what we here to talk about though, man. We got the biggest fight, man. I've been waiting for this fight forever, man. These people should have fought 3-4 years ago, man. We've been waiting for this. This is the super mega fight. We got Errol Spence versus my man Terrence Bud Crawford, and it's coming to you this Saturday, man. But like, this just I just got shaking my head to it. This is a hard fight. I don't know. I really don't know. But what do you think about this fight coming up?
Nah, it's bigger for real, man. It's like you said, the biggest fight of the year, bro. This is bigger than, in my opinion, Tank and Garcia, bro. That's been in the talks for a minute. Man, that boy Errol Spence, boy, 28-0, 22 knockout wins. He's different. Last fought with Ugas, that one was pretty crazy too. Then, like you said, that boy Bud, that boy quick. His footwork is crazy, bro. His footwork, if you watch, is crazy enough where he could like. He can counter, like, you know, his opponent, but then, like, land his own counter is crazy. But to be honest, bro, I really think Crawford got this one in the bag, bro. I think Bud got this one in the bag only because of his quickness, you know, his ability, his defense is crazy too. And experience as well, bro. Bro been fighting since 2008. You know, that my boy been in the ring for a long time, you know. So it's, I feel like Bud got this one in the bag.
And the thing what people don't realize with Bud is Bud was he only has one belt. He's the WBO belt because at one point he was a super lightweight. I mean, he's a lightweight, a super lightweight, then was to weight. It was just climbing up and climbing up. But back to what you were saying about Errol Spence. I ain't gonna lie, he shut Ugas' eye. Like, they had to end the fight. They had to end the fight. Because he shut his eye. Like, his eye was done. Like, they said no more. Like, it's over. But, like, Earl is, like, so... It's like, to me, the fight is, like, 50-50. And it's one of the hardest fights I could tell. Like, I don't think nobody's getting knocked out. But it's just gonna come down to just fundamental and skill. I feel like Spence
probably... It might come down to, you know, split decision, you feel me? Because both of them are such great fighters, you feel me? But like I said, man, I think Bud got this one in the bag.
And honestly, though, bro, like you got to think about it like this. You got to think about, they really have been fighting the same people, too. Mm-hmm. If you want, because they was talking about that at the little press conference. They was getting each other face. He's beat Danny Garcia, whooped him by unanimous decision. I believe... The score is judged it like judged it something like 116 to like 112 or 113. Either way, he whooped Danny Garcia. Danny Garcia ain't no slouch, you know what I'm saying? Errol Spence beat him. He beat Sean Porter. He didn't finish him, but he beat him. He beat him too. And he's just been fighting the greats, and he fought Ugas. Before that, he got in a car accident, which prayers out to him. I'm glad he survived and made out that car accident. He could have died in that car accident. That was a terrible car accident. He came back better. He fought Ugas, and when he fought Ugas, people thought like, cause his I believe like something fell out. It was either his mouthpiece or his teeth, and it's from a cartilage of the in his mouth from the car accident.
Right.
But people thought like, cause Errol smiled at it when he got hit. He smiled at it, and that's the first time like, I seen him like, oh, somebody like stunned him, though, but he didn't really get stunned. He came back, jabbing him, was staying in the pocket with Ugas, wasn't afraid of him, and really closed his eye. And that's the thing I like about Errol, because Errol can be skill, or he can get dirty with you. He could go in there, he can give you like, he ain't gonna stand there and get beat up, but he'll stand there and keep jabbing you up and give you some good hits. That's what I like about Spence.
And that's what I like about Spence too, bro. His ability to like go with the flow of the fight, you know? Like he doesn't have to like speed up or, you know, slow down or nothing. He figures out the pace.
He's gonna fight you at his own pace.
Yeah, you feel me? And that, but at the end of the day, that's gonna be before he knock your head off, because he will knock your head off.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. With like, it's just really, like I said, I feel like honestly, my man Spence, he has more. I see him on the Pivot podcast, and he was even talking about this himself. I feel like Spence is more technical in boxing, more technical, and Bud is more skilled. He's more. Not skill, like more talent. He has more talent. That's the word. Like, he has more talent. Spence, I mean, Crawford's reach is crazy. Like,
his reach is crazy.
He's quick, like you say. He's going to move off his feet. He's going to switch between his feet. I've seen him fight Kell Brook. He was switching his feet a lot when he fought Kell Brook. And once he, like, figured out his zone and got, you know, comfortable, he knocked Kell Brook out in the fourth round. And Kell Brook's hands are made of bricks. He closed that distance, knocked him out, him in the fourth round. Earl Spence had fought Kell Brook too, and he beat him in the 11th round. So they fought the same people. They both fought Sean Porter. I can't stand Sean Porter. I'm sorry. I don't like Sean Porter. I don't like Sean Porter. I ain't going to lie. But Sean Porter fought Crawford. This is what Crawford was arguing at in the press conference, because when he fought Crawford, Crawford knocked him out. He knocked Sean Porter out. That was Crawford's last fight. And then when Earl fought Crawford and went, I mean, not Crawford, my man Sean Porter, and went to decision. You feel me? And it's like they've been fighting the same people, my man. Like I said, Terrence ain't fight Danny Garcia, but Earl did. And like I said, it's up in the air. I don't know. I don't know. I really don't know. Like, this is about to be one of those fights you talk about with like Tommy Hearns, Ali, Frazier. Oh, this is a great fight. Like, this is about to be a great fight. Sugar Shane Mosley versus Floyd. Like, this is about to be one of the most legendary fights, because I feel like boxers, they don't want to blemish that perfect record. They're both
right.
They both have never lost a fight. So they both are like, this is really about to see who's the best. You know, like I said,
they're both hungry for the belt.
Exactly. Crawford got the WBO belt, and then Spence got the rest of the belts. Because Crawford moved up from super lightweight to welterweight some time ago. But it's like, and Crawford, like you say, got 30 knockouts.
Right.
Oh my goodness, he be taking people heads off. But it's like, I really don't know. And I feel like kind of like Floyd kind of messed boxing up in that sense that boxers don't want to fight each other no more. Like back in the day, they fought. Like a lot of them fought, like, you know what I'm saying? Floyd got that perfect record, and now you got it in the game of boxing where I don't like that's why this fight took so long, because it's like I don't want to punish both them perfect records. They could have fought a long time ago, but now I feel like they built their resume up so much that this is about to be a perfect fight. This is about to be a super mega fight. 2023 has had some great fights in general. I'm not gonna lie. You know what I'm saying? This is an off
UFC
topic.
UFC and boxing. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. This is an off topic, but we got my man Charlo. He about to fight Canelo. I think he's about to get killed. He went up two weight divisions to fight Canelo. That's in the works.
That's
two
about
days
to be crazy,
ago,
bro.
Exactly. And then 2 days ago, we had Stephen Fulton. He's from Philly, too. Philly, I don't know, man. Y'all be producing them boxes, Philly and Jersey. I don't know what y'all got going on down there, but they always produce some good boxes. But Stephen Fulton out of Philly fought my man Zinu. Zinu knocked his head off, like I said. But it's just like with this I'm really like on the edge of my seat to see the Spence and Crawford fight, man. Like, we all wanted this, man. All boxing fans, man, y'all wanted this for a minute, bro. I was sick of them fighting other people. Sean Porter got beat by Sean Porter beat Danny Garcia and got his belt. I'm like, bro, that's cool and all that, but I don't want to see Earl versus Sean, Terrence versus Sean.
But bro, this is the question I actually meant to ask you earlier, bro. Do you think this fight is going to go all 12 rounds?
Yes.
You think
if
so?
If someone gets knocked out, knock on wood. Someone gets knocked out. If someone gets knocked out, I do say it'll be Spence. But that's like a 0.2%.
Yeah. It's not
that's that, worst case scenario.
It's rare. Yeah.
Cause it's hard because Spence is gonna jab you. He gonna jab you to death. But
you also gotta think about this. Bug got a powerful and lethal jab too.
He do.
His recent jab is crazy.
That's why I'm saying like Bud uses his reach and his talent to his advantage. He has long reach. He can, like I said, he can move with his feet. He did that to Kell Brook with switching stances and all that. And he generates a lot of power when he be switching stances. That's really rare too.
Mm-hmm.
He be generating a lot of power off that. And it's just like, and he's fast. They're both fast, but I think Bud's just a little bit faster, but I do think that Errol Spence has a little bit better defense, and it's just like I said, gonna jab you, and he'll stay in the pocket with you, but he ain't gonna get hit. Like they both know that they both don't want to get hit by each other because they know how powerful it's gonna be. So right. I think coming out like the first and second round, they just gonna fill each other out, fill each other out, ain't gonna be nothing crazy. Later up, they're gonna pick it up. And it's gonna be a war, man. It's gonna be a war. Like
it's gotta be, bro. This is what we've been waiting for, bro. This is what we've been waiting for. I'm not even gonna lie to you, bro. So yeah, it's gonna be a war, bro. But it's gonna be like runs for real. Like you said, they're gonna figure each other out, but they're not gonna overtire themselves out too quick. So cause like you said, they know each other's strengths and weaknesses. So, but yeah, I see what you mean, bro. And I also believe it's going to go all 12 rounds, bro.
And another thing about Spence conditioning is crazy. Like Spence could stand in that ring for 20 rounds if he wanted to.
Oh, 100%.
Like Earl Spence's conditioning is crazy. He doesn't get tired. Granted, Bud doesn't get tired that much either, but Bud hasn't fought. He's fought more fights, but most of his fights end shorter, you feel me? Errol Spence, most of his fights, not most of them, but some of them have went to decision. More of his fights have went to decision than Terrence Bud Crawford.
Right.
And I seen a press conference. Bud said he ready. He in Vegas right now. He ready.
Right. He ain't about to say, I'm not going to lie. Ready. This is nothing new to him. This ain't nothing new to him. This is, like, to us is a big fight, but to him, it's just another fight.
And I just another like the fight. Way I like the way Earl just carry himself. Like Earl, like real chill. Like he just. Mm-hmm. I remember I was watching the pivot too. He just said, "I'm standing there like 12 rounds, and I'm just going to whoop him. Like I'm just going to take his soul. Like I'm just going to whoop him. Like we both respect each other. But yeah, my man Spence, he's funny, man. Like he's really chill, and he just knows what it is, man. Like he really honest. He just knows what it is." Basically, though, too, like, about how they carry themselves is they both carry themselves, like, humble. They both respect each other. Like, at the end of the day, they could talk all on that press conference, but they know they respect each other. They know they respect the power. They said, Spencer said that they talked on the phone before this fight about family, about boxing, about life and all that. So they definitely do respect each other. And it's just two backstories, two tips, right, where it's like, this is a perfect time, like, Spence had the car accident that really should have killed him, like I said. Like, thank God that he's still here. And Bud, he from Omaha. Well, what's it called? Country boy, too. Earl Spence, country boy, big country boy. Dallas, Texas. You know what I'm saying? And that, hey, I ain't gonna lie. Dallas, Texas be producing some boxers. You feel me?
100%.
There be my man's Charlotte. The Charlotte twins are from up there, too. But, like I said... what's his name? Crawford, my man's Bud, that boy from Omaha, Nebraska. That man said so he's just seen some crazy things. He's gotten shot in the head. He's recovered. And like, I don't know, man. This is just good backstory. It's good. This is the perfect time for them to fight, bro. This is the perfect time. 2023 boxing is back. It's been back. You know, I've always watched boxing my whole life. But
yeah, and I'm gonna go back to what you said about like you know that whole respect thing. Like, you know, it's a respect too when you know for a fact that they're not about to go in the ring and just start wilding. Like, you feel me? Like, they know, like I said, they know each other's strengths and weaknesses. So they, like you said, definitely about to feel each other out first before, you know, they start going crazy. But like you said, it's good to see, like, you know, them go at it for world, because, you know, at the end of the day, they hungry for that belt, like I said. But, you know, like I said, it's cool that they respect each other at the end of the day.
But, man, we ain't going to talk our heads off, man. Mm-hmm. Just know, man, y'all going to see our faces Saturday, man. Saturday,
100%.
Don't hit my phone. Even when the preliminary fights come on, bro.
I'm locked in.
One more thing before I even, you know, end it. I had to point this out because I just thought about something. My man's Boots, he's from Philly too. Gerard Boots, mm-hmm. Ennis. Watch out for him. He's on the come up too, behind Spencer Carver. He's not ready for them yet, but he's building up to it. Mm-hmm. Probably need to fight somebody like Danny Garcia or something again. I mean, not again. Like, he need to fight someone like Danny Garcia, you know. Get a watch little warm-up in. Yeah. This man just came out for dub. You know what I'm saying? It made him look easy. But the reason I brought him up for y'all viewers is because he calls, like, him and Crawford on the phone. And this man Crawford was like, it was the funniest call, because when Boots was talking to him, this man was real live just going on about how he don't want to see him. And then Crawford was saying, bro, like, come on, Boots. Come on, little bro. Like, stop talking. Let's be real here. Like, let's go back to sleep, bro. You drunk or something, bro. Go back to sleep. And my man's Boots would just kept talking. But watch out for him too, viewers. Watch out for him. He's definitely on the come up. But like I said, I ain't going to wrap your head off, man. You know what I'm saying? Don't hit my phone Saturday. Don't even think about it, man. Don't think about it. When this fight comes on, I'm glued to the TV for y'all, man. I'm glued to the TV for y'all. We might give y'all some. Stay with us. You know, you might get some post-fight reactions. You know what I'm saying? We might even go live, man. So y'all really need to stay tuned with us, man.
You never know. Watch out for the IG polls, too. We do need y'all opinions. Who y'all think is finna win? And when we post, we're definitely going to keep a post on IG. You got a comment down below. Let us know what y'all think. And keep subscribing, too.
Man, keep liking, comment, subscribing, like my man Zay said. And that's it, man. We hope y'all enjoyed this vid. We out.